Alright, just got through firing a Colt AR15 A4. This is not the first time we have brought this rifle out. This is the first time we've been able to video it. The last couple of times it's been either rainy, kind of, or just didn't work out. Now this one's been modified some. I mean, just minor things, mostly what people would do. But essentially the AR15 A4 is what you'd expect. It is the semi-automatic version of the M16A4. Which is currently in use for the Marines, although I believe it's being phased out in favor of other more modern designs, but it's still in use out there, and I would imagine other branches have a few of these in their inventories. Now, what the A4 is over the A2 is essentially it has the same 20-inch government profile barrel with a 1-in-7 twist rate, rifle-length gas system, but it has a Picatinny rail on top, just like on the M4. And that's really pretty much about it, to be honest. You know, it has a few other modernizations. For example, these Colts come from the factory with an ambidextrous selector. Some do, some don't. It's just whatever they put in that day. Still has an A2 buttstock with storage compartment inside. Yeah, it's pretty much your basic AR-15 rifle that Colt's doing. It's really kind of the spiritual successor to the SP-1, just kind of a simple carbine. I mean, excuse me, rifle. Not a carbine like all the M4s we see today. Now this one I have modified a little bit to make it into an M16A4 clone by adding a Knight's Armament M5 rail system. This has Knight's Armament covers on it. This is a Knight's Armament foregrip. Harris bipod, which is also in use on some of the military guns. This is a Chinese Acog clone, because what would I need with it, a real Acog? But it does the job, it gives the look. It has a MATech flip rear sight underneath it to use as a backup if the scope goes out. Just unscrew it and use that. Other than that, it's in stock configuration. It does come with one Magpul P-Mag from the factory. It does not come with the sling. I just threw it on there because it's a nice long sling that works well with the bipod. I have sold quite a few of these, and people seem to agree it's just nice to see a rifle from, you know, Colt or anyone. There's so many M4s out there, especially today. It must be just relieved to see a rifle. Other benefits of the rifle would be it is going to be a little more accurate because of the longer barrel. They are more reliable because of the longer gas system, a nice dwell time between the muzzle and the gas block. You know, has a full size fixed stock, so no wobble there. And yeah, just it gives you a little more range and all of that. Of course, it is longer and heavier, and this is not too bad. The Knight's M5 rail system is actually quite light for being what it is. It's not a very heavy rifle compared to, you know, some of the others you see. But yeah, we just thought we'd share this. You don't see a whole lot of these out there, and Colt doesn't make a whole lot of them. Seems like they just come around every few months. You see more of the flat dark earth ones than you do just the straight black. But when this came in, it had just standard A2 circular handguards. It had a removable carry handle on top, which I still have, of course. It came with one Magpul P-Mag and then manual in a cardboard box. So, you know, not a whole lot of accessories, but then again, they tend to retail for $1,000 or less, so. It's a Colt rifle, brand named and all that, but it's proven very reliable, much what you'd expect. Of course, no felt recoil being a heavier weapon, but just this kind of nice. It goes well with my M16A1, M16A2, those guns. It's the continuation of that series. Probably going to be one of the last full-length AR-15 rifles the U.S. military ever uses. But, yeah, just thought we'd share it in. Thanks for tuning in.